nerves?
I brought you your sleeping medication, honey.
Is it night already?
It's 9:30.
Well, what about the day?
What about it?
Well, was it a beautiful day? Was the sun
kinda
out?
Warm.
Was it warm? Were there clouds up in the sky?
I suppose. I never was much for staring up at the sky all the time. It's time to take your temperature now.
Please. There's one more thing, nurse. When will they take the bandages off? How long?
Very soon.
My face. It's pretty bad, isn't it?
I've seen worse.
Ever since I was a little girl, people have always turned away from me. I can remember a child screaming when she looked at me. I never really wanted to be beautiful. I just wanted people not to scream when they looked at me. When, nurse? When will they take the bandages off?
Easy, easy. Let's take your temperature. Just roll over for me now.
Oh, that's cold.
Ever see your face? 307?
Indeed I have. If it were mine, I'd bury myself in a grave someplace. Poor thing. Some people want to live no matter what. You want a cigarette?
You've just been introduced to Miss Janet Tyler, who lives in a very private world of darkness. A universe whose dimensions are the size, thickness, and length of the swath of bandages that cover her face. In a moment, we'll see what's under them, keeping in mind, of course, that we're not to be surprised by what we see. Because this isn't just a hospital. And Janet Tyler, patient number 307, is not just a woman. Because this happens to be the Twilight Zone. And Miss Tyler, with you, is about to enter it.
Good evening, Miss Tyler. We can have those bandages off shortly. I imagine you're very uncomfortable.
Well, I'm used to bandages on my face.
No doubt.
It's hopeless, isn't it, Doctor?
That's hard to say. Up to now, you haven't responded to any of the treatments. Nothing we've done so far has made a difference at all. However, we are very hopeful for what this last treatment may have accomplished. But there's no telling, of course, until we can get the bandages off. Would you like a mirror?
No, thank you. No mirror.
All right, then. I want you to remember this, please. Miss Tyler, are you listening?
Yes, I'm listening.
Now, we've done all we can do. If this final treatment has not achieved the desired results, please remember you can live a long and fruitful life among people of your own kind.
That's the alternative? If I'm still terribly ugly, I'll be put away?
Under certain circumstances, Miss Tyler, the state does provide for people like you, but there are many factors to be considered in the decision. Remain quiet and keep your eyes open. I have to insist, Miss Tyler, that you promise you will remain rational with no tantrums or violence. If you don't control yourself, we will be forced to control you. Do you understand?
Yes.
Here comes the last of it. I wish you every good luck.
I can just see you. I can distinguish your outline, but I can just see you.
Good. All right, Miss Tyler. I'm going to remove the last of the bandages right now.
No change! Needle, please. Pull her tight.
No!
Ow! Wrong arm! Wrong arm! Turn on the light.
Stop that deferment!
Smith.
Oh, good. I see you met Mr. Smith. He's a representative of the community you're going to live with. It's your only option left.
We have a lovely village of people just like us. You'll feel a sense of great belonging. Get your things. I'll take you there.
Mr. Smith, why? Why do we have to look so... so ugly.
Now the questions that come to mind are, where is this place and when is it? What kind of world where ugliness is the norm and beauty the deviation from that norm? Do you want an answer? The answer is it doesn't make any difference. Because the old saying happens to be true. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder. In this year, or 100 years hence, on this planet, or wherever there is human life, lessons to be learned in the Twilight Zone.